Hi, this is Doug Myers. I'm the Maryland Senior Scientist at Chesapeake Bay Foundation. I'm here to talk to you today about blue carbon. What's that? Well, blue carbon is the part of the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere that can get sequestered or put underground and stored there by different aquatic ecosystems. An aquatic ecosystem like the one I'm standing in right now. This is a marsh on the Migrate River in Anne Arundel County, Maryland. And in this marsh, I'm smelling a little bit of weird rotten egg smell. Well, that's kind of an important thing. It's hydrogen sulfide. It's part of the chemistry of the soils here. And it's part of the reason that marshes like this one can store carbon dioxide underground. As our carbon dioxide levels increase in the atmosphere because of burning of fossil fuels, we have some natural mechanisms to put it away where it belongs. And those natural mechanisms are things like trees and grasslands, and certainly marshes like this. The amount of carbon that can be stored in a marsh like this can be anywhere from 3 to 10 times more than a forest in the same period of time. And the reason it can do that is these marsh plants grow very quickly. And then they die every year, and a lot of the carbon that's in the tissues of those plants can get covered up by mud and sediment and water. And it prevents those dead plant cells from decomposing and putting their carbon dioxide back into the atmosphere. So bear with me a second. I'm going to dig a hole in this marsh mud so you can see what I'm talking about. On the surface of the mud, you can see it's a nice brown color. That's because oxygen can get in there and can interact with those soil particles that are on the surface. And then they're going to keep things very well oxygenated. But I'm gonna dig down here where you can see my shovel, and it's really mucky, and I'm getting a lot of dead leaves, a lot of dead roots from the grass, and a lot of really black looking mud. I lied to you. That wasn't a good hole. That one has too much oxygen in it because of the roots. Some of these wetland plants can actually pump oxygen down into the root zone for themselves to, oh, you hear that? That's the sound I wanted to hear. Good and mucky, because there's lots of water down there. Oh yeah, that's it. That's the stuff. Well, I'm in the shadow here, so let me get out of the way. So the blackness of the soil that you can see there in the hole means there's no oxygen getting below the surface zone. So any of the plant roots that are in there that die, they're gonna stay kind of mummified in the soil, and they're not gonna decompose, and they're not gonna put their carbon dioxide back into the atmosphere. So this mechanism, blue carbon, being able to use aquatic ecosystems to store carbon dioxide underground for long, long periods of time, is a really important function of the marshes we have here in the Chesapeake. Now, what's the problem when we go forward in time and the sea level changes? Well, look around here in this little cove on the Migrate River in Anne Arundel County. A lot of different land uses. You can see that the marsh that I'm in is very low. It's at the bottom of a hill, and it's collecting all the sediment, all the nutrients that are flowing through the forest off the houses up on the hill. And then it's gathering here in these mud flats and marshes. But if you look over here, you can see a bulkhead. And that's just a common erosion control technique used along the shoreline. If there was ever a marsh there, it's gone now, and there won't ever be one, because as the sea level rises, there won't be any room for a marsh to establish. So really important is that as the sea levels change, marshes need to migrate. They need to go uphill as the sea levels rise. And as they're doing that, then they're able to continue this function of storing carbon underground in the soil. Really important to that is the kind of stuff that we put in its way. Not just the bulkhead like you saw over there, but imagine if there's a road along the side of this marsh, and that road would prevent the marsh from moving uphill. So those are the things we need to look at, our relationship with shorelines, and how we both build on them and rebuild after certain properties become inundated with the new sea level.
The marshes are very important for birds, fish, crabs, all that kind of stuff. And most of us know that, but I don't think we knew how much the importance of the chemistry that happens in the marshes is also important to us now and even more so in the future.